if an operator is offering you free fill or cheap fill, you can pretty well be sure that it's going to be contaminated.
Don't get on Facebook, don't get on Gumtree, don't accept anything that hasn't been certified.
In this area in particular, landowners have consent to build flood mounds, and to build a flood mound you need a lot of fill.
People are building flood mounds to keep their stock on, their machinery, their sheds, their houses, to get them up out of the floodwaters when it floods. And we've found that unscrupulous providers of the fill for them can provide contaminated material.
Contaminated fill can contain building and demolition waste, which includes brick, concrete and tile. It can include heavy metals and at times hydrocarbons, which make it smelly. We do find that contaminated fill can also include asbestos, which is obviously a particular problem for landowners.
If the material that they are having brought in isn't virgin excavated natural material, then it needs to be certified to be able to be used. They need to be provided with those reports and have those reports and keep them on file for a period of 6 years.
Landowners should be present when fill is being delivered to their property, make arrangements with the transport operators to meet them on site so they can let them in, and keep registration details of the vehicles that are coming in and the name of the driver.
For a landowner to comply with legislation, they need to speak to the contractor about the supply of the fill, obtain the reports, that the waste classification reports that are required, keep written records, and be vigilant about who's coming to and from your property with fill. Ultimately, it doesn't matter whether you are on hundreds of acres or a 500 square metre house block. If you have contaminated material brought to your house or your property and you don't know where it's come from, then the buck stops with you.